Who do we have here is Mr. Jack Tang, right? Thank you very much for welcoming us here, Jack. And I mean, this is an honor to be here.
Yeah.
It's good to see you and with the new model guitar. Okay, Jack, so everybody knows you. You are the one of the famous musicians that in Singapore.
Yeah.
So there are a few questions that we may not know. I mean, there are a few things that we may not know about you. So we just want to ask you a little bit of that. Is it okay for you?
Yes, okay. Please.
So the first question. We know Jack as the guitar player, the famous guitar player, the musician. But now we want to know a little bit more. How do you become a musician?
First of all, maybe I want to introduce myself.
Yes, please do.
So I'm Jack Thomrat. I'm a guitarist from Thailand. So I'm very happy to be interviewed by you.
Yes. Very happy to be here.
Yeah. This is like my new studio in Chiang Mai. So,
yep. This is Jack's new studio in Chiang Mai. You just moved here like 2 years ago?
2 years ago, yeah.
Yeah. It's a very nice setting, very nice studio, and all these equipments. We'll talk about that later on.
Yeah. Okay, for the question, so how I become a musician. So I really like music when I was so young, when I was like 3 or 4 years old.
Wow, that's very young.
Yes, very young. And I started to play drums when I was 4 years old.
So you started as a drummer?
Yeah.
Are all the family members musicians or music-oriented kind of people?
I think all of my family, they like to listen to the music, but none of them were musicians yet.
Okay.
But when I start to play guitar, it was because my father.
Oh, yes, that's because, interesting.
Yes, but he's like a hobby. Hobby is okay. Like he plays acoustic guitar with his friend, and it was very interesting for me.
Okay. So that's where you got your interest comes in. So you started to continue the playing?
Yes, since I started to play when I was like 10 or 11 years old.
It's really young.
Yes, with my acoustic guitar.
Just acoustic. No electric.
Not yet. So I just play with a very cheap acoustic guitar that my
father. High actions.
Yes. But it's very good to improve your finger.
Of course. Yeah. Get more strength and the accuracy. So, do you even take any guitar lessons back then?
I was like a self-taught.
Self-taught.
Yes. Like for maybe 7 or 8 years.
Wow.
So I play everything by my ear, you know, like listen to the recording and transcribed by my ear. And my first electric guitar was my friend.
Friend gave it to you?
He gave it to me.
That's
nice. It's like I play with him in the same band, and he quit to play guitar and he moved to play bass. he gave his
This is in the same
guitar.
Band as you?
Yeah.
I mean, how old was this? When you have a band?
When I was maybe 16 or 15 years old.
So your interest in music really stays with you for a very long time.
Yes, very long time.
So there's no like, maybe parents say, hey, stop playing guitar, go and study.
Yes.
Okay.
Every parents in Thailand, I think so. So if you play too much music, like more than like 6 or 7 hours every day, it's like too much. Yeah, because you have to study.
Of course. Yeah. So do you get any like help or self, since you're self-taught, any materials that you get books or something to teach or to just read or maybe practice?
at that time, it's very difficult to find like a very good
materials
yeah, in, especially in Thailand, you know. So I sometimes have to find in like a music magazine,
like a guitar magazine.
But it's like a Thai.
Oh, it's Thai a guitar magazine. Thai guitar magazine.
They have like a article in that like a simple chord progression, how to play simple scales, something like that. So I learned from that.
So yeah. You're really interested in that, and then you keep on reading and practicing. Yeah. So yes. How long do you practice in a day then?
I think more than 5 hours every day. When I'm back to school, I just nothing I want to do. Just only
finish homework, guitar. Right? Homework finish, right?
No, not finish. But and when I was 18, yeah. It's like a.
That's where you get serious.
Yeah, seriously. And my mother, she's, it's like a. I dropped something in the school, like a. From, I was like a.
The level of.
Yeah, level. Yeah, the level very low. And my mother, she was very concerned about
of
that.
Of course, yeah.
And then I decided to quit to go to the university after I graduate from secondary school in. Yeah.
So you finished secondary school. You didn't continue university.
Yes.
So you focus more on music, especially on guitars.
Yeah.
Full time
is like for 1 year I stay in my house and practice.
Wow.
Like more than 12 to 15 hours every day for 1 year.
Oh, that's dedication, guys. Yeah. That's dedication.
Yeah.
So you really put everything in. You still have your band.
Yeah.
Still playing with the band.
Sometimes, but at that time my friend they went to the university. Yes. Yeah. So they didn't study in the music college, something like that. So
would you? I mean, if let's say your parents say, I ask you that. Would you like to be in a music college or university? Would you go for it?
I want to go after I graduate, but maybe I at that time I need to prove myself that
you're capable. Yeah, you are good at what you're doing.
Yeah, for 1 year I have to improve myself, and yeah.
Well, that's really dedication.
Yeah, yeah.
So after that 1 year, where do you progress to? Where were you?
At that time, I found very, very famous guitar instructor in Bangkok, and that 1 year I also study with him.
To learn from
him, and it's like he opened the new world for me.
It helps you.
Yeah.
So basically, you're saying that it's an education. It's a music education.
Yes.
I mean, is music education an important factor in your life when you play guitars?
Yes, it's very important because I used to play by myself, but
of course, yeah.
One day I noticed that I want to understand what
you're playing,
what I play, like what scale, something like that. So I have to find good teacher.
Of course.
Yeah, yeah.
So at least your families were being very supportive then.
You
wanted to indulge in music.
Yeah, yeah.
So let's fast forward. How do you get to where you are right now? I mean, the process must be long, and then you have done so many gigs, I guess.
Yeah.
That you get recognized. How do people recognize you?
I think it's because the Guitar Idol competition in 2009. Yeah.
So that's where people saw that. Hey. You got someone.
Yeah,
got our own talent there in Thailand, right?
Yes, I think that's because that competition.
And that's where everything goes well for you. You got offers and stuff like that.
Yes, okay. Yes.
So and of course you played for big artists in Thailand too, right?
Yeah,
like tour and
tour,
stuff.
Yeah.
How does it feel to become a session musician with big artists? When people first contact you, how do you feel? I mean,
so before that I used to play around Bangkok, like in the pub.
Like you played in a pub?
Yeah,
pub.
Yes. Before I played with the artist.
So you're working musician. Yeah. And, you're playing top 40s band. Yeah. And okay.
And then, first time I played with a big name artist in Thailand is very.
Can we know?
Yeah. Pami.
Okay.
She's a very famous singer.
So how do you discovered by these people?
It's like by connection, because I am a friend of a group of people,
in the music circle, yeah. Community.
Yes.
I mean, it's nice that how they can help you help each other in the music.
Yeah,
community.
Yes.
Oh, that's nice. So, but as a guitar player, there are a lot of competition in Bangkok, especially in Bangkok.
Yeah.
I mean, is there any problem? Do you think it's a healthy, is it a good competition?
I think you have to prove yourself, that you can play, of course. And you can get a gig, it's easier, but you have to be strong.
Of course, yeah.
Yes. Because so many musicians in Bangkok,
they gave up. Yeah. Because it's very hard, very competitive.
Right.
There's so many talented guitar players here.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. So and what's the biggest struggle? What's the biggest difficulty that you have faced working with session when you were doing session for big artists?
I think sometimes artists they want you to play like that, but
exactly as a recording.
Yes, it's like immediately. Wow. Sometimes you have to listen to the record before the show for 1 day.
That's not enough.
Yeah, and maybe 10 songs you have to learn in 1 day. Sometimes it will be like that, but I think for the musician we need more time.
Of course, yeah. We need to be more creative in the areas.
Right.
But have you turned down any offers, like big offers from artists?
Yes.
You do?
Yeah, I do.
Okay.
Yeah. Sometimes that, because I am like a very private person, so it's very, sometimes if I don't want to do it, so I just.
You don't want to do it. Okay.
Yeah.
So you can reject them, right?
Yeah, I can. Yeah.
You're fine with it.
Yeah.
So.